Welcome to biology class children. Today we are going to discuss transportation in plants. In our next class we will discuss transportation in animals. How the materials can be transported in plants we are going to discuss. In order to transport the materials in plants, xylem and phloem are useful. What is the use of xylem? Xylem is useful for transportation of water and minerals. Xylem is useful for transportation of water and minerals. Already we studied this point in 9th class chapter 1. Let us see. Phloem. It is useful for transportation of food and other organic matter. Food and other organic matter transportation can be done with the help of phloem. If you observe xylem, it contains tracheids, fibers and vessels. Tracheids, fibers and vessels. With the help of these tracheids, fibers and vessels, xylem can transport water and minerals. Next, with the help of sieve cells, companion cells and sieve tubes, phloem can transport food materials and other organic matter from one place to another place in a plant body. So, up to here, this total matter we have discussed in our 9th class chapter 1. Now, we are going to discuss how the xylem transport water and minerals in a plant body. We are going to discuss right now. Okay, children, let us come to activity 5 in our chapter 3, absorbing root hairs. What do you know about root hairs? If you observe root, let us see, this is root, there is a chance to see some hair-like projections on itself. So, these hair-like projections are called root hair. What is the use of root hair? In earlier classes, we have studied that roots are responsible for absorption of water. What is the use of root? Roots are useful for absorption of water and also minerals. Water and minerals can be absorbed by roots. Okay, children. But now in 10th class, we are going to discuss not only roots, root hairs. Root hairs are useful for absorption of water and minerals. If you observe the root, there is a chance to see some hair-like projections. These hair-like projections are called root hair. These root hairs are useful for absorption of water and minerals. Absorption of water and minerals. What do you know about roots? Roots are located. Roots are the underground parts of plant body. Underground parts of plant body. If you observe the roots and root hairs, these all are located in the soil. Soil contains soil water. This soil water and minerals can be absorbed by root hair, and then root hair can send into the roots. Roots can send to the apical parts. Apical parts of the plant body. What are apical parts of the plant body? Stem, branches, leaves, flowers, fruits. These are the apical parts of plant body. So, now we are going to discuss the absorption of water by root hair. Let us come to see the figure 16. See this figure, figure 16. LS means longitudinal section. Niluga katchedam. LS of root showing relationship of root hair and soil water. Let us see this total part up to here, from here to here, up to here. This total part is root. Next, what do you know about this white colored hair-like structure? This white colored hair-like structure is hair, root hair. So, if you observe the root part and root hair part, both are embedded or both are inserted or both are lies in soil particles. Soil particles. So, these are the soil particles. Soil particles contains soil water. What they contain? Soil particles contains soil water. If you observe root hair, it contains a nucleus in it. Plant cells contains nucleus in it. So, root hair also one of the part of plants. Plant. Next, root hair are embedded in soil particles. Next, it contains soil water in it. Next, it contains a nucleus in it. In soil, some spaces are there. In these spaces, air can be seen. So, these spaces are called hair spaces. Next, cell wall of root hair. If you observe the root hair, it contains a cell wall around itself. What do you know about outermost cell in plant cell? Cell wall. Cell wall is the outermost cell in plant cell. So root hair is also covered by cell wall. Next, vacuoles. Already we discussed in class 9. A big balloon like structures we can see in a plant cell. So these balloon like structures we call as vacuoles. What is the use of these vacuoles for storage of water and some waste materials in it? Next, in this root hair there is a chance to see cell sap. Cell sap means plant juice. One type of plant juice. What do you know about these? These are cell cortex. Next, these are xylem vessels. Xylem vessels are useful for transportation of water. These can carry the water and minerals. Next, what do you know about these? These are epidermal cells. Epidermal. Next, mesodermal, endodermal. Three types of dermal tissues are there. Epi means outer. Outer dermal cells. These are. Okay, children. Let us see, if you observe the root part and also root hair part, it contains both are embedded in soil particles. Soil particles contains water and also minerals in it. If you observe the root hair part, it contains cell sap. Cell sap means it's a one type of plant juice. Cell sap means one type of plant juice. If you observe the cell sap and water concentrations, water contains more dilution. Water contains more dilution when compared to the cell sap. Cell sap means plant juice contains less water, but soil particles contains more diluted water in it. So outside of the cell wall there is a chance to see less diluted water, means outside of cell wall contains more diluted water in it, more water in it. But inside of cell wall means in root hair there is a chance to see less water. As a result of these concentration differences will be developed inside of root hair. So the water presented in the soil particle simply enters into this root hair part and simply it can spread into the neighboring cells of the root hair part and then enters into the epidermal cells to cells of cortex to xylem vessels. Then xylem vessels can transfer the water to apical parts of plant body. Okay, here osmosis plays an important role. Whenever the concentration differences can be seen in the cell, in between the cell sap and water, soil water, then what will happen? Because of the osmosis process, water can be entered, water and minerals can be entered into the root hair, and then root hair to xylem vessels, then xylem vessels can transfer the water and minerals to apical parts of plant body. So this information we are going to discuss points wise. Let us see, soil water concentration is more dilute. More dilute means it contains more water in it. Okay, more water in it than that of the cell sap. Cell sap means already we discussed one type of plant juice. Cell sap in the root hair. Where is it located? Cell sap. Cell sap is located in the root hair. Next, here osmosis plays an important role. Because of the osmosis process, water presented in the soil particles will enters into the root hair. Okay, let us see. The entry of water dilutes the concentration of the root hair vacuoles so that it becomes more dilute than its neighboring cells. Whenever the water, diluted water enters into the root hair part contains neighboring cells. Some cells are there. So these neighboring cells can be diluted and then these cells will transfer this water and minerals to their neighboring cells. Like this manner, simply water and minerals can be spread from one place to another place in a root or in a plant body. Okay, let us see. So water passes into the neighboring cells, which in turn becomes diluted. Finally, water entered into the xylem vessels. So finally here the water enters into the xylem vessels has their vast number of root hairs. If you observe any plant root, it contains vast number. Vast number means uncountable. Millions of tiny root hairs we can see. So because of the presence of vast number of root hairs, what will happen? Root cells are also involved in a pressure in the xylem vessels and develops which forces the water upwards. Because of the presence of vast number of root hairs in a plant body, then what will happen? Pressure will be developed by the xylem vessels. As a result of this, water can be moved towards upward direction. This total pressure is known as root pressure. What it is called? It is called root pressure. This root pressure is useful for absorption of water and minerals in a plant body. Let us come to activity 6, children. Here, what is root pressure? We are going to discuss in this activity 6. For this activity, we need to take a regularly watered potted plant. We need to take one potted plant and we need to cut the stem portion 1 centimeter above the ground level. So we need to cut the stem of that particular potted plant just 1 centimeter above the ground level. Then connect a glass tube by means of a strong rubber cork. Let us see in this activity. So this is a potted plant. Already we have cut down the stem just 1 centimeter above from its ground. Next, we need to insert a glass tube with the help of a strong rubber cork. Here, pink colored one is strong rubber tubing or strong rubber cork. So next, then the glass tube should be equal to the size of the stem. Here we need to take the glass tube for insertion. Its size should be equal to the stem. Okay, next, take care while joining the tube and being bound tightly. Next, during this process we need to fix it properly and tightly. Next, so that the water cannot escape from the tube. If you fix it tightly, then what will happen? Water cannot escape. Escape means velli podu, denunchi tube lonchi bayatiki karipodu anamata. Next, now pour some water in the glass tube until the water level can be seen above the rubber tube. Okay, now we need to pour some water in the glass tube. How many ml water has you like it? For example, here in this experiment, I'm going to pour the water up to 10 ml. Okay, next, mark the level of the water as M1. Here I marked M1. Okay, initial water M1. Next, in the tube, keep your arrangement aside for 2 to 3 hours. How many hours we need to keep it aside? 2 to 3 hours. Then the observe and mark the water level as M2 in the tube. After 2 to 3 hours, if you observe the water level in the glass tube, then what will happen? The water surface level gradually increases. Now again, with the help of a marker, try to mark the surface level of water as M2. But in this total experiment, he forgot to give this point. We need to keep this above arrangement inside of a water vessel or water basin. Then only the root hair parts of a plant body absorbs water. Okay, let us see the difference between M2 and M1 indicates the level of water raising in the stem because of the root pressure. The water level increases in the tube. So if you observe M1 and M2 differences, then the differences between M2 and M1 gives us information about the water raising water by the root pressure. Let us consider example. Initially, if I poured 10 ml of water in the glass tube And after 2 to 3 hours, if I absorbed 15 ml in the glass tube, okay, if you see the differences between M2 and M1, 15 minus 10 means how many ml increased? 5 ml increased. This 5 ml of water is increased in the glass tube because of the which pressure? Root pressure. Because of the root pressure. So by using this root pressure, plants can transport water and minerals from one place to another place in a plant body. Okay children, today's class is completed. Tomorrow onwards we are going to discuss remaining topics.